Hey, welcome back to Tortoise Valley, where we are in the middle of a heat wave. So we're working at night, sleeping in the daytime, and we are trying to clean ourselves, get ourselves all sorted out after a raid in which we got a brand new colonist, namely, right over, where'd he go? There he is, Vincent Rogers. And Bjorn, what are you doing? We actually really need you to move these dead bodies because you and Seth are the only people who can do it. So I'm gonna get them out of there kind of as fast as we can. So we'll take a minute right here at the beginning to make sure those guys get moved. You're already working on that one. So Seth, once you get him down, are you going to get the last one? No, you're going to do more hauling. So yeah, you get... All right, nowhere to store it. Okay, that's a bit of a problem. Actually, that doesn't need to be a problem. We can actually just expand this stockpile zone out a bit. And now there should be no problem at all getting him moved. And yeah, let's unforbid that. And don't know. That was forbidden. Oh, it was a knife. Yeah. All right. Unforbid that. Everything else looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. We've got people mining. Now, some stuff has got to get taken care of. One thing is we have put this right here. But what we want to actually have in here is mainly just personal shields, and we also want them to be just any quality. Let's see, nothing less than 40%, I think. So that stuff will get moved. Okay, good. And this is gonna get turned off as well. So people are gonna go to bed here. Well, it'll be a little while. It's 5 in the morning. They're gonna work till around noon or so and then sleep the hot times away. Looks like Dax got this finished, so hopefully our cooling system will keep things cool enough in here that people aren't going to get too hot and uncomfortable. That's the hope. That's the hope. Now, other thing is going on is we have got a poison ship down here, and at some point we're going to have to cope with that. It looks to me as though the poison isn't really getting very far. I don't know, maybe it'll spread out to here. But okay, we need a research project. Yes, we do, and what we need are auto doors, because what I said I would do is put in some auto doors here and here, so when Dax go about, when there's fighting and we have Seth and Dax kind of hold up here, people start running away, they can run out behind him and just start clubbing him. So we want to get that done. And yeah. So we want stuff to be getting moved here, and it looks like actually there's not much in here to move over to there. Steel is stored there instead of up here. That seems wrong. Let's put this as preferred, so that'll get moved. And one thing I said is really worrying me that I want to look at real quick while everyone is asleep here is that I just don't know that we are getting enough work done on the block making. I think we're running out of blocks kind of really easily. So if we come to here, look at our work. Who do we have for crafters? Seth, who will craft, but only after constructing, repairing, and mining and hauling are done. Sindingbat, of course, but we're having her mainly work on the hats. That storage we got to fix up too, by the way. Fiish, actually, you're hauling, which is fine. I've got you on cooking and all that. Maybe you could do some crafting. Let's look. Lucie has a kind of wants to do it, actually, as well as the art. So right now we have her doing art and then cleaning. Maybe we should have her on the crafting. Just not sure. Lonely could do it, but there's not really passion in any of these people. Sindingbat, of course, is amazing, but she's, you know, the backbone of our colony. So, yeah, actually, Vincent, who we just got, that's art. He's pretty good at art. Let's do this. Let's have Lucie come actually, and do the crafting before the art. Craft, then clean. And then Vincent, let's have you, we don't need you to doctor, doing this stuff. I don't think handling is really needed right now. We could have you hunting. Although, I don't know, that's a possibility. Let's have you do crafting first. Oh wait, sorry, no, sorry, what am I thinking? Art first. And then hunt, mine, you wanna mine? Hunt, and then haul and clean for right now. That might be a way of doing it. Someone's got some items to trade. So, Murmu, doing a bit of hauling. You can come and chat with Lilith here. We also need to keep working in here on this hospital. So we'll get on that once we're done with the trading. So we've got a lot of stuff, but she doesn't have much, you know, money here. So let's go buy. Okay, we could buy these lavish meals from her. Don't want to buy any of her drugs, really. She doesn't have any beer. We could buy her good medicine. That looks good. And then we can just start selling her stuff that we don't want till... Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Not our beer. Not our beer. Bad idea, Bjorn. Keep the beer. All right. The pistol. We'll just kind of come on down here. Let's keep all of these, I think. Yeah. All the low percentage stuff for sure. And then, yeah, we're already ahead of the game. Okay, actually, she's got a cloth duster and masterwork cloth pants. Maybe just by selling off some of these cowboy hats. I mean, let's just sell all our cowboy hats. And then superior duster and masterwork pants. Okay, that's still more than she can afford. We're buying everything she's selling, I think, except her drugs. I don't really want those. So let's, okay, take back then something we're selling. Maybe one of the hats. This one's superior. Okay, let's see. This masterwork one. We have two of them. We'll take one of those back. Take both of them back. That will work. All right, now it looks like the hats, well, that we sold them out, but they are, the ones in here are getting kind of, you know, they are falling apart. And is that because this is unroofed? Or yeah, it's outdoors, so we want the roof area to go right there as well. All right, hopefully that will get that sorted out. Now, as I was saying, it was a manhunter pack, manhunting muffalos. Oh, that's a lot of manhunting muffalo. Let's see, but I bet we could handle these. Let's give it a try. We don't really have a good way to stay indoors and safe. I wish we had more of these laying around, but we don't. So let's switch that on. Murmu, you come to here. And actually, let's do it this way. Everybody get drafted. Murmu, come. You're already working on that? Okay. So let's do what we did before. Our people, okay, Seth can come to there and Dax can come to there. Our people who have distance weapons. So in particular, actually, you know, Lonely, I think for the Manhunter packs, there's so many of them, grabbing the other minigun would be smart. But now I don't see it. Where'd that minigun go? Let's see. Okay, I guess I'm genuinely blind. I cannot find that other minigun. I do not know what has happened to it. Which is unfortunate, but it is what it is. Anyway, let's get our rifles to here. Sindingbat, Hawklady, Fiish, Halfweed. I'm going to bring you to there. And now let's get our other rifles, our charge rifles, to there and to there. Is that everybody? Oh, and Vincent has one to there. And then let's bring our SMGs to here. Oh, Murmu's got to get drafted here. Wait, I didn't even switch yet. Dang it. Yeah, all right. Good guy can go to here. And that's everybody. So, yeah. Murmu, you flick that switch. And now you get drafted and come to here. I guess cover is not, like, a huge thing. I'm not sure. And Lilith is hanging out up there, so they're not going to bother her at all. So they're going to come down the side. Okay, I hope we're up to this. I'm not above bringing Seth and Dax out if we need to. But I mostly just don't want people getting shot by other of their friends, you know what I mean? All right, slow it down. All right, take him down, folks. Take him down. One's down. Minigun. Oh, wow. Look at that go. All right, keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up. Nice. Okay, hold it. So, Seth, can you... Okay, all right. You got there pretty good. All right. Lonely's been hit. Just had your other middle toe torn off, which is unfortunate. Good guy. Can you guys fire at this Muffalo here? Guess you're attacking this one as well. Yeah, Seth, you're getting this one? Oh, wait. Okay, they're still going. Okay. That's everybody. And everybody stand down. All right. So good guy, you're bruised. You don't need any medicine. You're fine. Seth, you're bruised. Same way. And Lonely, have lost your left fourth toe. So that's unfortunate. 80%. We're going to have to get you like a bionic leg or something on your left at some point. But let's give you, what's our medicine supply like? I think herbal medicine will be fine if we just make sure we have a really good doctor. So Sindingbat's at 12. Yeah, let's just only have Sindingbat do this. So Lonely... You're going to rest. Yeah, you rest until you're healed. And everybody else. So let's... for these, let's hunt them. Let's have them hunted. And let's actually... I think Vincent... We'll let him hunt. Kind of first. We could let Bjorn do the hunting as well. And we can turn this back off. But we survived the attack, which is good. The hunting will get done eventually. That should give us a nice supply of muffalo meat and nice supply of berries, too. That's always nice. So, okay. That's going to be a thing that's going to have to happen. So this research is almost done, which is nice. People are sleeping now, though. I forgot. We're in the middle of a heat wave. So I'm going to let them sleep. I'm going to check the temperature while they do, and we'll see them when they wake up. Okay, people are starting to wake up. I actually don't know. Alright, Sindingbat has not actually tended yet to Lonely, and that needs to happen. He's not bleeding terribly, but, you know, I don't want to be infected. Let me just make sure it's nice and clean in here, but I think it is. Yeah, nice and clean. I think we're just going to give him, this kind of medicine, hope that that's going to be good enough. But... Everybody was doing fine for the heat. It was like in the 70s and 80s, except for these people were not happy. Understandably. And so we need to get this sorted out, but we got a problem. Partly we need to get Okay, we need to get stuff moved out of here. So jade, we should store that in here, I think, as well. So that is in raw resources. So that can get moved. But I want to actually take this completely out and part... Good, heat wave's over. So let's go ahead. It's 3 a.m. Let's keep people on this schedule for right now. And then when they go to... When they're about ready to wake up after the next schedule, I'll switch it over. Anyway, what I was saying... okay, so we need to get... I keep starting to do and then not doing... This all nice and built. But the other thing that we really need is to get some cooling in here. And I have an idea about how I'd like to do this. But it's gonna... We're gonna have to get rid of this first. And I want to build some stuff kind of down here as well. So it's gonna take a little bit of extra thinking. So we're gonna have to get rid of... That wood is there. Is the wood... The wood is not full over here. So I think, yeah, make this a preferred priority so it'll get moved out of here. Someone's a minor risk. Lucie is unhappy. Just because she's hungry and a pessimist. Well, you know, if you're going to be a hungry pessimist, that's what's going to happen. I'm kind of worried that I didn't find the other minigun, and I wonder if that is because of, like, I accidentally sold it and didn't mean to. And Dax... has accepted Seth Matthews' marriage proposal. So happy, happy news. Congratulations. I think it is time. Let me check the beauty. Is this? No. Yeah. This is a bunch of negative ones and stuff like that. I wonder why that is. But what I want to make this into a park area. So... And I thought it'd be nice if it's a park area, we should, you know, we could make it a nice little marriage spot in there too. So we can start on that as well. It's not as priority as this stuff here, but let's get working on that. First, let's put in some growing zones. I think maybe a strip right there and just a little strip right down there. It doesn't have to be... I think this is going to be a little bit more organic. It doesn't have to be super duper, what's the word I'm looking for? It doesn't have to be super duper symmetric or anything like that. Okay, 19. And it's about, yeah, people are waking up. So I'm going to pause it, come back to the restrictions. And now what we had before, we'll give it to everybody except for Halfweed, who we want on the night shift. But we're going to give everybody where they'll have... They'll wake up at 5. They have 7 hours. 2 hours there. 3 hours of joy in the morning. And then working throughout the day. Okay. And, oops, I give it to Halfweed. I didn't want to do that. Didn't want to do that either. Hitting all the wrong things. There we go. But we're going to switch up a little bit here. We're going to move this back an hour just to, you know, get that kind of change. But then we're also going to make these two be work. 3 hours of joy and then wake up and 2 hours of anything and then work. And so you're still having joy time with everybody else. That's going to be the plan. All right. And I've been so distracted with those Muffalo and getting stuff built. I have forgot. We have got to meet Vincent. So who are you, man? So you were a cult child. This is Vincent Rogers was born into a powerful cult which shunned advanced technology and believed that all illness could be cured by cleansing the soul through sacred art. After your first glimpse of the outside world, you decided to run away. So no medicine, got some artistic stuff. Wait a minute. Oh, no, not no medicine, just it's gone, knocked down a bit. So I guess in rebellion, you ran to a glitter world and decided to take up surgery. Take that, mom and dad, in your cult thing. and you were on a world mostly free of disease and human suffering, though, so you mostly had to do elaborate and creative cosmetic surgeries. You are, in fact, ugly, so you didn't work on yourself, apparently. Or maybe you did and did, like, experiments and didn't go right. You have a good understanding of human biology, but never had to remove a cancer or a bullet. So that plus three to medicine just basically balanced out your minus three. But you got a good bonus to art, which is good. You can't do intellectual. You're jealous and you're ugly. We could put you on the night shift being ugly. We had some success with Squishy doing that. But more importantly, I think since you're jealous, are you getting upset? Yeah, someone's doing better than you. What is your bedroom? Which one is yours? Here it is. It's a 16. Yeah, here's an 18. 23, 23, 23. So let's put Fiish over here. Sorry, Fiish, but you seem to be pretty cool with different stuff. That kind of thing. And we'll put Vincent over here. There we go. Let's see. Is that going to cheer you up? Let's get rid of this. Yep. Now, all happy. Let's see. It's nighttime, so people should be going to bed here pretty soon. Or maybe not. Wait a minute. Yeah, it's 0 o'clock. I guess they all got so much sleep. They're not really tired right now. Now, this, I think, we have it set to somewhere that Lucy's working on this. Let's add another bill to make a large sculpture. And we'll allow 11s to do it. And allow stone blocks. I think that'll do. So Vincent can maybe get on that. Okay, so this, hold it. We said marble. We don't have any marble. We have almost no marble. So that was kind of a mistake. I'd like to get the marble done, though. So, also, this needs to be getting done. Yeah, we're doing good for the hats. Let's suspend the hats just for a little bit. See what else happens. Okay, Vincent is now working on some sculpture. I like that. Okay, Sindingbat is working on the meds. I like that too. I'm actually thinking once these meds are all made, what we'll do is we'll put in hospital beds. Like, you know, good hospital beds. Now, what I was starting to say before is that to do this kind of upright, we need to move this stuff out of here. We need to get rid of this storage area entirely, but what we don't have is a good storage area for weapons. And we want to be able to sell those too, but it makes sense. Well, it kind of makes sense to put them down here close to the area where we do the, you know, fighting and all that. But it kind of doesn't exactly make sense to do that. Let's haven't been planted yet. Let's go ahead, though, and put the marriage spot in. It's miscellaneous, is that right? Yeah. Right there. We'll spruce it up as time goes on, but if the marriage happens before we get there, maybe we'll have some flowers at least. And, yeah, okay, good. Hops is getting sorted out. Very nice. So we should be able to get some beer here eventually. That'll be a nice thing. But I'm still not sure what to do with these weapons. I'm tempted to put them in down here. Because it's real close to, you know, the fighting. The problem is we sometimes have to come up here and I want to have to run all the way down and all the way back up to get weapons. That seems like that's going to be a little bit, I don't know, like wasteful or something. Also, who on earth is doing our cleaning? Because it is a mess around here. Lucie, no. Lonely. Murmu, let's have Murmu clean now before he hauls and then can do art after. Plant cutting being first and foremost. That cleaning's got to get done. Someone's got to work on that. Look at this muffalo meat. Oh, it's lovely. Lovely. And we should have some buffalo leather somewhere. Now, one thing is, this stuff, we can't actually sell this to anybody because it's not over here. And this is where what's hit by the trade beacon. So I don't want to have to build a trade beacon. So I'm not quite sure. It actually makes sense to me, to be real honest. Let's mine this out a little bit more. And then we'll just switch them out. We'll put the cloth in here. And then the other stuff in there. Because we want to be able to sell, you know, if you've got like just 31 pig skins or like 14 elephant skins or whatever. That's just sell that to get rid of. Oh, and there's some more cloth. It will be really needed. Also, I keep thinking there is no reason we couldn't put some doors up here too. Anyway, we'll worry about that later. It's time for sleeping. Halfweed's going to make some beer. Everyone else is going to take a rest. So we'll see you in the morning. All right, people are getting up. They're going to have their breakfast, do their all their morning type stuff. But while they're doing that, I want, like I was saying, I want to get this hospital a little bit better. The next thing we need to do actually is mine this all out, because we're going to want to put power in there. And feeling pretty confident we're going to want it there. And then we'll, let's also go ahead and put in, it's going to be a little pricey, but I think we can afford it. Yeah, we can afford it. The sterile tile. There and there. Get working on that. Seth, yeah, good digging. Just want to see, also, as long as you're digging, is there any other places where we should be getting out? Could actually go ahead and dig out this right here. Use a little bit more steel. Never have too much steel. Also, we need to not forget to have our crafters, you know, they should be working on this sometimes. So literally somebody, yeah, Lucy's doing that. So good, we're working on that. Hopefully we're getting some stone cutting done. Must be getting some done because we did get enough marble to build that there. But I'm gonna put slate all back here now just because I think it's slate time. Got a lot more of that. And we should move these. Dax. Oh, we're getting the wrong ones. All right. There we go. Whatever. So we'll get the whatchamafidget, the power put in as well. You know what? I just realized some fog came and I realized I had completely forgotten about this poison ship down here. It's fine. It's not doing anybody any real harm. I mean, I don't think it's killed all that, has it? Maybe, yeah, maybe it did kill all that. Still gotta think about that. I think that's not gonna be today. We're in the middle of eclipse, middle of fog, and I'm really, really just wanting to get this sorted out. So we can also put in, I think, a hospital bed. And I want Bjorn to make that. There we go, because it's a thing that it does, you know, quality does matter for that, so we want our best builder to work on it. Putting in the power there, we'll go ahead and put in some lamps. But also, it's time to put in some vitals monitors. So 180 steel, I think, yeah, we can afford that. Let's put this one in right here. And this is our high tech, you know, high quality room. And the other ones will be good too. But this is like if we got an operation or something, let's send the person to there. So people are going to head back to sleep one more time. We're going to let Halfweed. Halfweed, what are you doing? Some growing? I haven't been keeping an eye on it. But so he's having no problem keeping up with the meals. So good stuff. All right, we have got ourselves a raid. A group of pirates from the Skunks of Anguish have arrived nearby. It looks like they want to use sappers to tunnel around our defenses. And Fiish has a brother coming in the group. Now, let me just look around. Here they are. What do we got? What are we looking at? Got two melee, one grenadier, one incendiary launcher. Watch out for him. A sniper rifle. Wouldn't mind one of them. And a couple of charge rifles. Now, I don't know where they're going. This could be really, really interesting. But looking at the time, this raid is going to take some time to get done. And we don't have it. We don't have it. It's episode will be way too long. So apologies for the cliffhanger. We are going to call it right here. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you soon.